Sometimes we get mixed signals. Maybe our intuition, our perception, or past experiences make us not the best at reading people. Thankfully, all is not lost. We can get better at reading people, but how? Number one, our gut instincts. A majority of people don't trust their gut feelings. We usually trust our brains and believe what our brain tells us to believe. But a study from the University of California shows that people only recognize lies 43% of the time, and truths 48% of the time when trusting their brains. When trusting their guts, the accuracy rate was way higher. Trust your gut, because first impressions are often accurate. Number two, speech and behavioral mimicry. Some people, the first time you meet them, put up a false persona or try to manipulate your perception of them. The people who are actually being honest and genuine, though, will mimic your words and actions. This shows they're in sync with you and how you are feeling. Number three, empathy. Some people have a natural talent in empathizing with others, while some don't. To be able to increase your empathy, you need good reading and understanding skills. American psychologist Carl Rogers thinks empathy is important in his teachings and therapeutic methods. Empathy will help you see things from someone else's perspective, and thus will allow you to read their emotions and intentions better. Number four is appearance. Making judgments on appearance might feel shallow, but it can say a few things. Be like Sherlock Holmes. Hey, that dude is wearing prime condition Jordans. Maybe he likes basketball, rap, or at least sneaker culture. People's appearances can give you subtle hints into their character. Do they wear lots of colors? Are they very well dressed or very sloppy? These could hint that they're organized and diligent, or lazy and a slob. Number five. Similar to number two, body language is a major giveaway to someone's emotions. If someone's sad, they might suddenly have their head down with drooped shoulders. Are they anxious, sweating, pacing? Are they checking their phone? Maybe they're not into the conversation? Are their smiles just small grins? Pay attention and look deep into a person. Number six, facial expressions. This aspect of body language can be hard to interpret. Sometimes each side of the face can give off two different emotions. Some are obvious. Upturned mouths and crow's feet often mean happiness and smiles. Some emotions are a combination of different signs, like embarrassment. Some people, when they're embarrassed, smile. However, the lips are tighter than a happy smile. Lips might also be pulled tight when compassion is felt, as opposed to sadness where the lips are pulled down. While it's confusing, it's important to learn these subtle cues for a significant advantage in reading people. Number seven is objectivity. With all these tips, it can lead to some bias. To successfully read someone, enter the situation objectively. Leave your past feelings of that person behind. Focus on what they're saying and how they're behaving in that moment. Our feelings can create a false impression of what they're conveying, especially negative feelings. And number eight is patience. In order to read someone, it takes practice. People are complex. If you're in a conversation with them, they're likely also picking up on your cues as well. You can't be an immediate expert on someone or automatically assume everything about the other person. If the communication continues, they will open up at their own pace. And that's when you can figure out if you read them correctly or not. That's all from us at Psych2Go. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.